Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. This video is educational video to show how Toa Payoh vets treat a hamster with skin disease. Now this hamster, 59 grams, is only around 6 months old, female, came in today with much inflamed lower body. As you can see, you can zoom in and see it's very red. And this is the beginning of inflammation, because if you don't treat it, it becomes wet and full of pus and very smelly. That time is very hard to treat because the skin is all rotting. So now you can see the owner came in with this complaint of this redness, and there's a wart there, a wart here, a big wart, the wart which I have already excised, and I will clean it. So now I'll demonstrate how we treat this hamster. It's already been treated. And now, firstly, before clipping the hamster board, I put inside a chamber, a container, and I will switch on here 5% isoflurane gas, and I run the oxygen flow to about 3. And okay, then we come to the gas will come to here, and the hamster will be anesthetized so that it's easier to treat. And it takes about a few seconds. You can see that the hamster will be not so active after breathing in the 5% isoflurane gas. So the vet has to be very observant. Once the hamster is not moving much, it's time to take it out and do the clipping. Now, okay, now you can see it's already down, almost down. Okay, so I take it out. I take it out now. I switch off the anesthetic machine. Okay, this is only a few seconds. Now I take it out and put it here, and I use the clipper to clip. I mean, it's been done. This is more like demonstration clipboard, so that it's easier for the owner to wash. After green board, then I take the scissor and the forceps to cut off the wart. There's a skin wart here, and the skin wart is here. Okay, this skin wart is cut off because it will irritate the hamster. Now there's a hole here, but this will heal very well. Now so when the hamster is under anesthesia, then I just clip the infected area, clip everything, and so that the owner can do a good job washing away the bacteria and any fungus or yeast on the lower body. The lower body is the one which is inflamed, but I have also clipped the top part so that so the owner can compare and look out for any infected area. So now after that, I use this antifungal wash here. I will put it in a swab. Put a bit in the swab here, okay. Now, you do it 2 times a day if possible. Of course, now the hamster is a bit down, and then what I do is I give it a first wash. You shouldn't wet it too much because it will catch cold, so just enough. Okay, then quickly take water and rinse off. So, you prepare everything in advance. Of course, in this case, I just rinse it off again, the antifungal wash, rinse off, and also the dirt. Of course, it's not so easy to do when the hamster is awake, but this hamster is a very gentle one. So I do 1 time for the owner first, and after that, they'll have to continue washing. Then rinse it off with either cotton ball or a swab, or the swab, the sterile swab, not sterile, actually the ordinary swab. Just clean off, hold the scruff of the neck, the scruff there, so they can hold the hamster in case it jumps off the table. Then you just rinse off all the dirt and the scales. Oh, it's not so happy, I know. But after finishing, then we put back the hamster into the container and let him dry up. And essentially, that is to be done at least twice a day, if not at least once. And basically, change the litter to either paper or soft one, because the owner has been using cat litter pellets, which are very sharp. So this is how we take care of a hamster with ventral dermatitis. Okay, finish.
Press again now.